welcome back to my channel. I know that all of my videos this week have been sit down videos and I feel like I've been talking so much, but a lot is going on right now. I feel like I have just a lot to share and a lot that I want to record so that later I can look back and go, oh, that's right, you know, or just remember the times. Yeah, just remember the times. So that being said, this video is going to be all about being 12 weeks pregnant and how I'm feeling and what is going on in my life. We do have a little change that is possibly happening in our life, in our family, and it will completely change our entire world. It's gonna change everything. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start with my 12 week update and kind of the symptoms that I've been going through, what I've been thinking about, and you know, this is the last stage of the first trimester. Thank goodness. A part of me is like, wow, this pregnancy already seems to be going by so fast. And another huge part of me is like, let's just get it over with, you know? Let's just get it over with. So I'm gonna try and keep all of my thoughts together and in order and easy to listen to, okay? All right, so today we are, we're 12 weeks and one day. So I turned 12 weeks yesterday. So it's a little bit earlier than I normally do my pregnancy update videos. I don't know why. My brain, that's one thing I will start off with. This week, my brain fog is intense. Yesterday, I was trying to tell my husband about something, and I just couldn't get my thoughts to form to be able to say a cohesive sentence. I just couldn't, and I'm like, we were just laughing. I was dying laughing because I kept trying to say it and weird words were coming out that didn't, like, it was not in order. It was so funny, but it was at the same time like annoying because I was just trying to tell him something that was actually funny. And you know when you try to start telling a joke and you get the joke messed up, and so by the time you're done trying to figure out how you were supposed to tell the joke, at the end it's not even funny anymore. It was kind of like that. So, pregnancy fog and mommy brain, those are real things. Yeah, they're real things. So I stumble a lot when I'm trying to talk, and I know I'm gonna probably stumble with this video because there's so much on my mind, there's so much that I wanna say, and I just have to focus and keep it all together and pretend like I'm trying to, like I'm actually talking to someone will help too, because, I don't know. It's difficult when no one's asking you questions or giving you verbal feedback. So there's that. And then, you know, I don't really have any days where I feel sick. I have more and more bloat feeling. I get pains in my abdomen. Especially if I'm sitting down, like if I'm sitting down holding Jake Jr. and then I go to stand up to like lay him down or whatever, I get pain in my stomach and I can tell it's the muscles, and I don't know, you know when you pull a muscle and then you say you pull a muscle in your arm and then you leave your arm in this position and then you like go to use your arm and it hurts really bad? It's kind of like that. It's like a pulled muscle that stayed. I can't hear speak. It feels like a pulled muscle, but in my stomach, and it feels weird. So there's those pains. I'm peeing all the time. I mean, I probably pee, like normal me, not pregnant me, pees twice a day. Pregnant me pees like 7 times, 8 times a day. And that's crazy for me. I'm trying really hard to drink water. I'm not doing that great of a job. I know I'm not getting enough water, and I just keep trying to tell myself, drink more water, drink more water, drink more water. I went for my first doctor's appointment, which was really just like a nurse appointment, and they get your blood and labs and stuff, and urine. And I went and had that, not last week, but the week before. And now tomorrow I go and have the first doctor's office ultrasound. And then the next day, Tuesday this week, I'll have my next doctor's appointment, and that's when they want to do the like a pap smear, and they'll culture, I think it's culture, for two other types of STDs, which I think is crazy because I was literally just tested when I was pregnant with Jake Jr., and I was just pregnant with him in 2015, and so I was just tested for every STD under the sun, and I was negative. And, you know, now they want to do it all over again. Like, the other week when they drew my blood for the labs, they took 10 huge vials of blood. And I was like, oh my god, my body has been working so hard to make some extra blood, and you just took it all. Like, literally, you just took almost probably 40 milliliters of blood from me. I thought it was kind of crazy. So, I'm going to ask the doctor Tuesday if she really thinks that it's going to be necessary for me to have another pap smear and another STD check, like the way she wants to check for it. I mean, if she says yes, then I'll do it, because I do know that if you are positive for STDs while you're pregnant, that increases the likelihood for a miscarriage, and then of course you can pass on an STD to your baby, so I definitely don't want to do that. But you know, nothing has changed in my life. I'm still married to the man, same guy, we're faithful in our relationship, so I don't see how that's really necessary for me. So I'm gonna see what the doctor says, and I'll let you know for sure. I should find out some of my labs on Tuesday at that doctor's office, or that doctor's appointment as well, so that will be interesting to see if it's any different at all from 2 years ago. What else? My face is not as, like, the pimples aren't as big, but it's more all over my face. The acne, the breakouts, whatever. And I'm noticing that they're more like, they're not, like, I'll get a couple pimples, but I get mostly like weird red bumps. And they're like, they're not normal pimples, like acne, or at least that I get. So my skin is crazy, and my hair is crazy. Yeah, I'm about over it. I'm just over it. But anyways, I think that being pregnant makes your milk supply go down. Actually, I shouldn't say I think, I know. Because the more pregnant I get, it seems the less of a milk supply I have. I mean, Jake Jr. at this point, I mean, he's just getting little tiny snacks when he nurses. And so it really seems like he nurses more for comfort than for any kind of, like, food supply or nutrient. So I'm really, fingers crossed, hoping to wean soon, because I'm really getting over it. I have sore nipples from being pregnant, and so every time he nurses, I'm like, it's not like really, really painful, but it's sore. Like, I just don't want them touched, you know? So it's been really hard to nurse. I just don't even enjoy it anymore. I just don't want to do it anymore, and I feel bad, but at the same time, I know that the only thing Jake Jr. is really getting from it is the comfort. And so, you know, for that reason, I still love it, and I'm still happy to give him what he needs right now, but I am hoping that as soon as he's done teething, I can start the weaning process. I just feel like it's about time. It's about time to wean. I'm over it. I'm over it. So hopefully we will be weaning soon. I've only gained about a pound since being pregnant, and again, I kind of contribute that to the breastfeeding and not drinking enough water and just being more of an active person, meaning actively after Jake Jr. I'm always cleaning something, cooking something, straightening something up. You know, I do have a lot of times where I can sit, and that is nice, but I think that Jake Jr. keeps me so busy that I'm not gaining weight like I did when I was pregnant with him. I'm also not a, like, I'm not eating, I'm eating very well, but I'm eating healthy. I don't know how to explain it. I just think that I am not taking in as much as my body is using up or giving out. So I hope that that's okay. I'm going to talk to the doctor about it on Tuesday and see what they say. Like, I hope that, you know, there's not any issues. I had no issues gaining weight when I was pregnant with Jake Jr. So I know every pregnancy is different. So I'm trying not to worry or get too caught up on how much I weigh or whatever, but I've only gained a pound and I'm 12 weeks. So I can't remember. I think by now with when I was pregnant with Jake Jr., I had gained 4 or 5 pounds by this point. So who knows? We'll see. Still very out of breath, and I still have days where I have no motivation, no energy. Like, my brain is saying, okay, we want to do this and this and this. But my body is like, don't move. I'm not gonna let you move. We're shutting off the part of your body that says move around. You're not moving. So that's frustrating. Those days are frustrating. Today is not a bad day. Like, the past 2 days I've actually had energy and I've gotten things done. So that's been really nice. And I'm hoping that I'm out of the woods as far as like the really low energy, real fatigue kind of days. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and give you a shot of my belly. I think I have a pretty good little baby bump. And I'm not gonna measure, I don't think, because I don't really think that I'm much more than last week. So the life-changing situation that I was telling you about. So today my husband left to take the ASVAB to get into the Army. Yeah. I haven't talked about it before because I wasn't sure how serious he was about getting into the army, about going into the army. But, you know, it's to the point where he's applied, now he's going to take the test. And if he passes all the tests and is admitted, then the next step is he chooses which job he wants, which, like, he'll qualify, like, whatever his test scoring is and medical scoring. I think this is how it works. They give him basically like a list of jobs that he qualifies for, and then he'll pick which one he wants to go for, and then he goes to basic training, which is like boot camp, and then he would go to the schooling for whatever job it was he chose, and then we would move to wherever we're gonna be stationed. That is a lot. And I'm serious, like, that's happening right now. I know, we're 30 years old and just going into the military. Seems kind of crazy, but his reasons are super and admirable. Did I say that right? Admirable. And so I'm excited for him and I'm proud of him and I'm just excited for him. I'm hopeful for him and I hope it goes well. Like, my nerves, I told him when he was leaving not to be nervous, it'll be okay. But my nerves are actually pretty intense right now, just because of if he gets in, this means so many things and this means so much. So, whew. Anyways, Oh, I can't imagine going that long without him. And I'm crying. Okay. Why he wants to pursue a career in the army. First of all, let me just say, he doesn't want to just... He's going in with all intentions of, you know, doing 20 years and retiring when he's about 50. And his reasons for it are, when you're full-time in the military and you retire, the retirement is really well, especially with your ranking when you retire. So that would be guaranteed retirement, guaranteed health insurance for however long he's in, and health insurance that you don't pay for. It also is guaranteed money for myself or Jake to go to do more college, guaranteed money for Jake Jr. and this baby to go to college. I'm gonna cry again. I've been fine, but he literally left today. So it's just becoming... It's becoming more and more real. So, it's a lot of benefits to being in the army. Plus, it's been a dream job of his. It's something that he has always wanted to do since he was young. And... just never pursued for different reasons. And when we were first together, you know, because I'm from an area that has military, I dated a couple people that were in the military and they went overseas and, you know, I did that whole thing, and which I was also like a teenager, and so you have to take that into consideration, but I really didn't like it. I really didn't like it. And I just told myself, I don't want to be with someone who can't be here with me. So when we first got together and he mentioned the military, I was like, I won't be with someone who's in the military. That's just too hard for me. But at this point, we've been together for 9 years, just about. And we're both... mature, or, you know, we're both adults, and we, you know, we have kids, and, or we're going to have kids, plural, but, you know, my life is so busy with Jake Jr. and about to be busy with two kids that they would kind of feel that void of companionship while he's gone. Not completely, but enough to where I'm not complete, like, I'm not alone. I still have my family, my children. So I know that I could handle it at this point in my life. So I told, you know, it came up maybe a year ago. And he was like, are you still absolutely no? And I was like, you know, I think that I could handle it. You know, I'm like, I think that I can do it. And so... now he's gone. So, we'll see what happens. We definitely talked about the possibility that, you know, we're 30. And there's a possibility that he won't be accepted for whatever reason. And, you know, he doesn't want to have to accept that, like, he physically couldn't pass the application process. And I don't mean physical strength or endurance, I mean we're old. So, but I told him before he left, you know, if you go in, we win. If you don't get in, we win, because we're not going to lose time with you. And in the end, time really is more important than anything else. So either way, we're going to win in this situation. It can only be good. And it's going to be an adventure. I mean, if we get to move like Hawaii or Colorado or wherever, or even stay here in North Carolina and we live in Fayetteville, there's an army base there, will be close to his family and my family, or I'll be close to them if he's not in town. So I'm excited. I think that it'll be good for us. I think that just having that mundane work, kids, I think we need a little mix-up in our life. I think that we need something new and exciting and an adventure and a change, and I think that'll be good for us. So we'll see. We'll see. I'm nervous and I'm scared. And I think, I didn't know I was gonna cry in this video. I think that I'm more nervous and tearful because it is such a big change. Because it would mean so much time apart. I had to get a handle on myself. I think it's mostly also pregnancy hormones. So, anyways, side note, I love sushi, and I don't mean raw sushi, I mean like cooked sushi, sushi rolls. And Jake doesn't love it, like he'll eat it, but he doesn't love it. And normally if he ever takes me for sushi, he'll just get the hibachi, but the soy in the hibachi foods really upset his stomach. So every time he ever goes anywhere, I always treat myself to sushi because it's my only real opportunity to eat it, because, you know, he doesn't want sushi or hibachi or whatever. So I'm excited because tonight I'm going to treat myself to sushi rolls. Yes, I'm probably gonna get two. I'm so excited about it. I cannot wait to eat some sushi. I've just been thinking about sushi all week long, literally. So, that's that. I guess when he's gone, I can have sushi all the time. Anyways, so that is what is new with us. We have a 16-month-old who's hitting. We're 12 weeks pregnant, and we might be joining the army. That about sums it up. Sushi. Anyways, I hope that you got a kick out of this video, and thanks so much for watching. Thanks for going on this ever-changing adventure with us, and I hope that you enjoy watching these videos, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.